Hello guys, today we'll be reviewing Man on Fire. So Man on Fire is a movie released in 2004. And Man on Fire is a very good movie. It's also a pretty long movie as well. So if you have a shorter attention span, you will not like this movie. And maybe so let's go watch Monsanto another time. But, or Turning Mid. And you know, we have the real movies to watch. But this movie was hated by the critics for probably absurd reasons, like Sonic 2 and Sonic and Alita, Ghostbusters, and, you know, other movies as well. You know, it proved that even back then, the critics, you know, hate movies that people like. Okay, the critics, you know, I don't really trust the critics. I think they're a bunch of, you know, phony idiots. So basically, this movie's about this guy who hires a bodyguard for his kid, and basically they state a fake kidnapping. So, and then the bodyguard, you know, goes after the guy who states the fake kidnapping being, and goes basically kills the whole organization because, of course, he's the one who started it. And of course, I'm not gonna spoil the ending, but yep, this is based off a true story as well. And basically, you know, this movie is a very good movie. You know, I don't care what the 49% Rotten Tomatoes will tell you, because this movie is further proof that you can't trust the scores on Rotten Tomatoes. But was this movie a box office success? Well, we're gonna see. So basically, we received mixed reviews. Of course, that mixed reviews comes from Rotten Tomatoes. But the fans really liked this, and this became like a cult classic, like movie probably. So, $60 to $70 million, so this movie was an okay box office success. Of course, non-franchise movies made more money back in the day. If this release was released now, it would probably made $10 million. And then, it would have movies like, you know, The Last Duel would have made. So, overall, Man on Fire is a pretty good movie. So, I would recommend watching the movie. And that is without the spoilers. I did tell you the basic part of the movie, but I didn't spoil the ending for you. Because that's basically what the movie's about. And I didn't spoil the ending because basically, you know, that would basically ruin the whole point of watching the movie. The ending is very, very surprising. There was also some pretty good action scenes and even some funny moments in the movie. So, yep, that's basically it. So, yep, this movie gets my seal of approval. Goodbye. And no, this stuff is not about the movie. That's about Twitter and stuff that's happening in real life. So, goodbye.